Hey everybody, Chris here from It's Mead Made, and today I'm going to be giving you my review of the LK4 X from Longer. So, let's get into this video. So the folks at Longer reached out to me and asked me if I would test their 3D printer and give a review of it. And I said absolutely, as long as I can give my unbiased opinion about it. So they went ahead and sent it, and this is my unbiased review of it. So that being said, I have been 3D printing for going on 9 years now, which is kind of crazy to think about. And I tell you what, I've had quite a few different 3D printers in the past, but this one has probably been the most easy to use. And if you're a beginner in 3D printing, this might be the printer for you. So that being said, I've actually broken this video up into different segments for you, so you can skip ahead if you want to the specific area you're more interested in. So I'm going to talk about the specs. I'm going to talk about the assembly of this unit. I'm going to talk about the features of this unit. Then the printing of it and how it actually fared. The results of those prints. And I'm also going to give you my thoughts on the printer. So feel free to skip ahead however you want to, or why don't you just watch the whole thing? So probably one of the biggest specifications that everybody wants to know is how big can it print? And it's 220 millimeters by 220 millimeters by 250 millimeters. Pretty much the same specs as an Ender 3. The print speed can go up to 120 millimeters a second, which is pretty fast. Now the cool thing about this 3D printer is the heated bed. It can actually get up to 100 degrees Celsius, which is really good if you're printing some of those specialty filaments and maybe even ABS. And the nozzle temp can get up to 250 degrees Celsius. So when the LK4 X arrived, I brought it down to the studio and started unboxing it and assembling this thing. And it came with all of the right tools that you need for this 3D printer to put together and just to work on. Now, it came with a scraper, and one of the nice things is it came with a nozzle wrench. I mean, I've got a nozzle wrench because I've bought so many nozzles in the past, I bought one, and it's just nice to have one of these, and them to give you one is fantastic. So if you ever have to replace your nozzle, it's really nice to have one of these. Now, the one thing that I really wish that it came with, I wish it came with snips. It did not come with snippers that all of the other 3D printers I've bought in the past have. Because that is more useful than a scraper. Because with the mag plate it comes with, you don't need a scraper, you just flex it and pop it off. So if you're new to 3D printing and this is going to be your first 3D printer, I definitely recommend you buying some snips because it's not going to come with them. I was using my other pair a lot just for this, because you use snips every single time you change your filament. It's not a deal breaker, snippers are pretty cheap, but I do wish it came with that. Now, when it comes to the assembly, in their marketing, they say it's 90% pre-assembled. And I tell you what, that's 100% true. It's 90% pre-assembled. I mean, everything is already attached except the gantry. So you have to attach that top rail. And the nice thing about this is it actually has grooves already machined out to where they fit in perfectly. You don't have to like take a square and make sure it levels perfectly like you do with some other machines that are just flat rails on flat rails. This has already got a specific spot where you put it in. Now, one thing I will say is the instructions, they were not super easy to follow. So I actually had to go to Longer and watch their assembly video on how to put this together, just to make sure I did it right. And lo and behold, I still put it all together and didn't do it right. In the very beginning, my very first prints, I was getting some weird lines. And I mean, I was like, oh God, I'm going to hate this printer. And they sent me this printer and I'm going to say how terrible this printer is. But I reached out to Longer and their tech support got back to me really quickly and told me that I needed to tighten my concentric nuts more because the actual hot end was loose. And lo and behold, I did not tighten it enough when I was assembling it. So after I tightened the eccentric nut, I mean, everything I printed was just beautiful. But that's one thing I feel like I would have gotten a lot better if the instructions were a lot more clear. So it's one of those things. If this isn't your first 3D printer, you shouldn't have any problems. But if this is going to be your first 3D printer, You're going to have to watch a video or something to see on how to fully assemble this thing. Now getting into the features, there's a lot of good little features on this machine that just makes your life so much easier. Now the LK4 X has an auto leveling system, and it uses 16 points to measure the bed and see where it's off level, and it corrects that. The only thing you have to do is figure out what your Z offset is. And you just follow the prompts on the screen and it's perfectly fine. And it just does it for you, which is amazing. And speaking of the screen, it's got a 4.3 inch color touchscreen, which is really nice. And it's quite responsive. And the interface is really nice. It's clean and easy to use. The interface is great for a beginner. It shows you everything that you need to know, and it's broken up into areas that just make sense. But the one thing that was a con for me was there was no advanced settings in there. Because I wanted to test my E-steps and see when the printer came to me, was it calibrated properly? So I had to 3D print a gauge and then connect my Beagle cam to actually push out 100 millimeters of filament. Now people like me that are wanting those advanced features typically has something to be able to plug into your 3D printer to get those features, like an Octoprint, or for me, I used my Beagle cam. But when it comes to a con, I would say that that is a very low priority on my list, because it's just something that I like to have, but you don't have to have it, especially when you're getting started in 3D printing. You just want to be able to hit print. And with this interface, you definitely can just plug something in, select your file, and hit print. So this thing comes with a silent motherboard as well. I know in one of my Enders, I've upgraded to the silent motherboard, and it is just as quiet. But the one thing that is not quiet is the fan that is on it. Now the fan does get loud, but I will say that when it comes to a 3D printer, it's still really quiet. But for those of you that like to get your hands dirty, you can easily replace this fan and make it even quieter. Now one of my favorite things on this machine is the PEI mag plate. Having a mag plate on one of your 3D printers is just fantastic, because you just peel it off and you pop it, and then it's done. I have a mag plate for my resin printer, and it's amazing. You never need to use a scraper. Even though this comes with a scraper, you don't need it. And what I really like about it is it's a two-sided PEI mag plate, because one side is a very smooth finish and the other side is a textured finish. And I've used them both and I've gotten great adhesion for both of them. You can print directly to it without using anything, or you can even use a glue stick. I printed a couple things on the clean plate, and then I also printed a few more using a glue stick, and they both turned out great. I just like a glue stick because it's that extra safety for me. And like most 3D printers today, it has some fail safes in place just to save your prints. It has a filament sensor detector, which you just kind of thread your filament right through there, and if it runs out, it stops your print. And it also has a power shutoff mode to where if you lose power, it will save where you're at and then pick right back up where you left off. Now, probably the biggest thing here, this is the biggest thing about this 3D printer that really just sets it apart, and that is the direct drive motor. So this is a direct drive. There's no Bowden tubes here or anything. The filament goes straight into the hot end and the gears push it straight through. And it's a dual gear system. That means you've got two gears on each side pushing it through. And that means there's less slipping of your filament and that clicking and snapping and popping that you hear sometimes when you have a Bowden tube, which means it is great for specialty filaments, like any of those flexible filaments, because you need to have a dual drive for those kind of filaments. But I've been using PLA, and I mean, it has been pushing through flawlessly. Now there's a few things on this printer that I was just like, oh wow, I'm like, this is nice, oh wow, this is nice. There's just like little tiny things on this thing that they just went the extra step of like, did they have to do this? No. But did they? Yes, they did. There's little feet on the back of the build plate to where when you're putting that PEI plate back on, it aligns it perfectly and it snaps just in the right spot. And this doesn't seem like it's a huge thing, but lining your build plate up and making sure that everything's good is just a pain in the butt sometimes. If you have clips Or if it is another mag plate and it like misaligns and you gotta take it off and put it back on. I've had plenty of mag plates before and it's a pain sometimes. And just those four little brackets make it so much easier to put back on. Another thing that's typically an upgrade for 3D printers is it has belt tensioners already on it. If you've ever had to tighten the belts on your 3D printer, you know exactly what I'm talking about when I say it is a pain in the butt. Because you have to keep pulling pressure on it while tightening the bolts. This has already got the tensioners on it to where all you have to do is just turn a screw, and that is it, and you've got them perfectly tightened. And this is just like an OCD thing for me. The one thing that I absolutely hate about my Enders is the rails. The rails have these grooves, and all my filament and all the little goobers and everything always fall in there, and I always have to bring in my shop vac to suck them out, because I just don't like them in there. But the LK4 X actually has smooth rails. And I know this is kind of a dumb thing to bring up, but it just stays clean. And I know, it's weird. And this design is just nice. It removes all of that. So there's no areas to where filament, like the little pieces of filament and stuff can get stuck. It's just a nice design. So I've had this thing for 3 weeks now, and I have been printing all PLA. Now, I was getting flawless results with all of the normal PLA that I use. So then I was like, okay, it's time to see if I can break this 3D printer. I went ahead and I also printed my rainbow silk filament and just straight silk filament, because on my Enders, I can never get anything to print good when it comes to these two spools that I've had for a while. And I think this is the biggest thing. The direct drive makes a giant difference. I mean, it just printed beautifully. In my quest to see what I can do to break this printer and make it not print something, I went ahead and I tried to print the one thing I have never been able to print. I have tried it on all four of my FDM machines, and I've never been able to print this Raphael. It's a flexi print, and I'm sure you guys have seen these things out before, but it's just one of the old action figures that is all support free. I've never been able to print it. And not only did I try to print this, I also printed it in one of my terrible filaments, my green silk, because I have so many issues with this silk filament. Until now, I have not had any issues with the silk filament with this machine. I can't believe it, honestly. I was throwing everything I could at this thing and it just kept printing. It's a workhorse and it's a beast. So here are some of the things that I 3D printed, and they printed out beautifully. So this first one right here is the Wonder Woman before I tightened the eccentric nut, and you can see these lines through it, and it just looked bad. It wasn't a terrible print, but there was just something wrong with it. Once I tightened that eccentric nut, everything just changed. And this is the print after I fixed that. And I did nothing to it. It's the exact same file and everything's beautiful. This is such a nice little model. And this is from Eastman. And this is just a beautiful model of Wonder Woman. But it came out great and I honestly can't wait to paint this one day. So then I printed another flexi part in silk filament. And I usually get tons of stringing when I'm doing any type of flexi anything with silk filament. But this turned out beautiful. It's such a cool little dinosaur, and everything popped off the plate beautifully, and everything works great with him, and it's a really nice print. So once I had the success with all of the silk filament, I moved on to the worst roll I have, and that's the rainbow filament. This is honestly one of those rolls that I've just had for a while. I've been wanting to throw it away, but I'm like, I'm gonna figure it out one day. And well, that was the day I figured it out. I just needed this machine and it would print just fine. So I printed this little vase and the vase turned out great. So once I printed that, I realized that I need to test this machine and see how big it prints. So I went ahead and took this vase and I scaled it all the way, as big as I could on the build plate, and hit print. And in about 2 days later, I got this. And it is it just turned out good. It's a nice little model, and you can actually tell it's silk filament instead of it's just being all yellow. I also ran a couple tests. I ran a Benchy, and I also did this Dragon that actually tests just about everything for you because it's overhangs and stringing. And they turned out great. So then I printed probably my most favorite thing that I did on this printer, and that is Thing from Adam's Family. I just got done watching Wednesday with my wife and we loved it, so I'm like, okay, I need something to 3D print, and I found Thing. And these prints turned out awesome. I actually tried my natural filament, which I do have troubles with sometimes, and had zero issues with this one, because I usually get some kind of clog with my natural filament. But this printed out flawlessly with that direct drive. Man, I love that thing. Then I printed out another version of that model full scale. So it is a big thing, and I am going to be painting this and making a project out of this, so don't you worry.
And one thing I will mention, that all of these 3D prints I have not processed in any way. If they had supports, I took the supports off, but that's it. So you will see a little bit of fuzz or, you know, stringing and that kind of thing. And I wanted to leave that just so you can see how good these things have 3D printed.
So overall, what do I think? What are my thoughts? Somebody that's 3D printed a lot and used a bunch of different types of 3D printers and brands out of the box and just with a little bit of assembly, this one, so much better. Because it works beautifully. That direct drive, oh my god, I love it. To be able to have that, I'm really going to start to experiment with some flexible filaments now. It's just all of those little tiny features that just keep stacking one on another that some of these other printers could easily do it, but they don't. This one did, and I am very, very happy with that. Because the nice touchscreen and interface, the filament sensor, the magnetic build plate, even those little guides on the back of the build plate to where I put my mag plate on and it just sets perfectly. And it's just easy to use. So if you're new in the market of looking for a 3D printer, I have to say this would be an amazing first 3D printer because it overcomes all of those little things that you have issues with and it's already there. Like the belt tensioner, that is such an amazing thing, and there's other 3D printers that you can buy those as add-ons, but you don't have to, it's just on it. And I swear, if my first 3D printer was a direct drive, I don't think I would ever get a 3D printer with a Bowden tube because, I mean, it just pushes the filament out, and it's used every single filament I've thrown at it. Even my junk filament that I just absolutely have hated in the past, now I'm like, oh my god, maybe I should start printing more silk filament. I was just trying to be really biased this entire time and be like, okay, is this even good? Is this good? And every single time, it's just like, wow, it printed this and it printed it beautifully. Now the one thing I will say, this review is only based off of me using it for 3 weeks. Now, long term, we'll see. I'm hoping that it's going to just keep doing what it's doing, printing beautifully. But over those 3 weeks, I have thrown some weird models at it to just see if they'll print, and every single one, it has printed beautifully. So overall, it's a good machine. If you're looking into getting another 3D printer or your first 3D printer, I don't think you can go wrong with this. And I'm sure you're thinking, yeah, of course you love a free 3D printer, but this is an unbiased opinion. They just sent it to me and I told them that I will give an honest review no matter what. And if you're okay with that, go ahead and send it. And they did. And lucky for them, I am fully backing this thing. I would definitely consider buying another one of these just to have two working at the same time. So I hope this review has helped you. If you have any questions about this that I didn't answer for you, feel free to leave them below for me. And my next project will be painting Thing, because I really want to see what these prints look like with some paint on them. So if that video is done, I'll go ahead and put it right here for you. Thanks a lot for watching, and I hope you have a great day, and I'll go ahead and see you in the next video.